The previous government was just doing bad governance in terms of education. But this government is completely politicizing the whole education sector, putting in people of their persuasion. They clearly haven't read the book, because the people who I've seen quoted are saying things about the book which just simply don't exist in the book. And let me just, since you've asked, quote to you a line from the preface, which makes clear what my position is. This book is written against both the government's militaristic understanding of the Maoist movement as a law and order problem that must be crushed, and the revolutionary certainties of the Maoists and their sympathizers. It is written for all those who hate the impunity and arrogance of the Indian state, who admire the Maoists for their sacrifices, but disagree with the wisdom of their path, and who recognize that violence, even against injustice, can degenerate into brutality and corruption. I'm sad that a university like Delhi University is being reduced to this, where decisions about what we teach and the kind of extracurricular seminars that we can have are being dictated by political reasons and not on academic grounds. There are several constituencies which the government is trying to keep happy with this. One is, of course, to deflect attention from the real culprits of the Bhima Koregaon violence, which is alleged to be Milind Ekbote and Sambhaji Bide. And secondly, they are trying to demonize human rights activists by in the same way that they try to demonize JNU and its students by calling them anti-national. Now the new term is urban Naxal. The third is, of course, to please corporates, because this will keep down any kind of protest against land acquisition, have a chilling effect on dissent in general. And the fourth is to whip up sympathy for Modi in particular by whipping up, by creating this false plot. So this is a huge witch hunt. None of these people, I can say confidently, were involved in Bhima Koregaon. Gautam Navlakha, Sudha, Stan, they weren't even there. So I really don't see that this has anything to do with actual evidence or cases. Among the several things that may not ever recover from this government are the environment and the education system, because they have systematically built upon the bad work that was being done by the previous regime to make it completely ungovernable and reduced academics to politics.